Rejoice our Lord in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Before I start reading, I would like to say my scripture verse again, because we, including myself, we need to understand how serious we got to be taking the rules of God. James chapter 1 verse 2 says, "Be ye doers of the word also, and not hearers only, deceiving your own self." Meaning that we know that the word of God is true. And when we hear the word of God, but we don't do the word of God, meaning practice the word of God, we are deceiving ourselves, because we are continuing to do those things that are not true. So let us not just hear the word, but take the word into consideration and practice the word of God. I want to read Revelation chapter 3 from verses 14 to 22. Revelation chapter 3, verses 14 to 22. And it says, "And unto the angel of the church of the Laodiceans," right? "These things said the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would that thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm, and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because thou sayest, I am rich, and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest that thou art wretched, and miserable, and poor, and blind, and naked. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thy eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous therefore and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him, and he with me. He that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and sat down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the churches." Verse 14, "And unto the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write, These things said the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God." First of all, the angel is the messenger of God. And John, we know, wrote Revelation. And the Amen, speaking about God. Faithful in the scripture is God speaking about himself. And the true witness, the only person who is the true witness of God, is Jesus Christ. Jesus was speaking here to the church in Laodicea. And you know, nowadays we have a lot going on in the church in terms of being lukewarm. But before I continue, I wanted to read John chapter 1, verse 2-4. John chapter 1, verse 2-4. John chapter 1 verse 2 to 4 speaks about the same was in the beginning with God. All things were created by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. That here we are also speaking about Jesus. Jesus was in the beginning with God. And a lot of people tend to think that some people talk about Jesus don't exist, some think Jesus was just a man. But Jesus was with God, and he is God. He was God in the flesh. And he is speaking unto the church. Verse 15 says that, "I know that thou art neither cold on your heart, and I wrote that down with cold or hot. What Jesus is saying is that he knows the things that we are doing up until this present day. He knows everything that we are doing. And these people who are lukewarm, he knows that they are not hot, meaning they are not, they don't have a zeal for God. They're not compassionate about the things of God. And they also still clinging on to the things of the world. Right? But God wants us to make a decision. God has given us the power of choice. Yes, God wish that not to repent, but I also come to repentance. But God don't call us his way to nobody. He gave us a choice. What he is saying here, he wish that we either choose to be called, be on the world, in other words, do the things of the world, or we choose him and him alone. He do not want us to be in the middle or decisive. As someone said, the last wife, when she left Sodom and Gomorrah, she still had the things of Sodom in her heart that she looked back and then she came into Sodom. We don't want to be like the last wife. But actually, I want to read 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 3. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 3 says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heed to themselves preachers having itching ears. You know, I have been in a position for August this year, we're making 8 years. I have been posting scriptures since August of 2012. That's when I was going through the whole demonic stuff. And from that day to now, I have realized that any time I post scriptures, especially the word of God, concerning scriptures to correct people that don't like it at all. But the minute you start to post about blessing and what God will do for you, that's what you love. Right? But God not going to bless you unless you obey God. Right? I want to read verse 16 back in Revelation chapter 3. Verse 16 says, so then, because thou art lukewarm and neither hot nor cold, I will pull thee out of my mouth. Because you're in the middle or decisive, the little scripture also talk about a double-minded mind. Your mind is made up. God don't want that. He wants to vomit you out. He do not want that. He wants us to make a decision. And as a choose either day who you will serve. Serve God or mama. The Bible tells us that Jesus was saying that you cannot serve two masters. Because either you will hate one and you will love the other. You cannot serve God and mama. Right? And God also said in his word that he will share his glory with no man.
Hallelujah.
Verse 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with good and have need of nothing, and knowest that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and needy. So these people, the lukewarm Christians, they're not hot for God, they're not running after the things of God, have a zeal for God. But they think that they're good because they have their own values, or they have riches of the world, the treasures of the world. They think they are good, but with God they are not good. Their spiritual life is not good. Because as a lukewarm Christian, right? When you stay holding on to the things of the Lord, God is not going to accept you, right? And the things that God, for example, lukewarm, this can be like, you're in God, but you still love to gossip. You're in God, but you still love to lie. You're in God, but you still love to do the former things that you used to do. Now, I am trying to make myself very clear. I am not talking about somebody who was a sinner, because we all were sinners. And repented and baptized and striving to live a God's prayer life. I'm not talking about that person. Yes, we have got to struggles. I have gone through struggles with former sins. But I am talking about people who are in God but yet do not want to give up the former things. They still love the things that are the world. They still love to bad talk. They still love to
today, we cannot pray 구하라기 때문에 구하는 것은 our serious spirit, 제 말씀에서 we know God is our spirit, and the devil is our serious spirit. And neither of them is to be played with. God is not to be played with such that there is just God, and if we don't repent, he can actually get rid of us. And the devil is not to be played with because he likes nobody. He has his intention, and the Bible says it's thief, kill, and destroy. So when you're in the middle, you really have yourself in some serious team because you're between the two of them. Right? Verse 18 says that I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thy eyes with eyesight, that thou mayest be poor. I speak about verse 18, I forgot the part about rich and miserable, poor and blind. So yes, I was saying that these people think that because they have earthly treasures and wealth, and they wear off and they think they're good, that everything is good with them in the sight of God. But really and truly, they are blind, spiritually blind, not being able to discern the things that are of God and the things that are of the enemy. They are really miserable because earthly wealth is not enough. With all the joy of the Lord, they come like they have nothing. Right? And nature meaning that they do not have all, I will call it, the garment of the bride of Christ. You know, we as the church are the bride of Christ. And our garments are to be spotless. But as a lukewarm person who is still holding on to sinful things, that person will have spot, and spot is sin.
Amen.
Right? So verse 18 is speaking about God wants to sell us a bad blood of him tried in the fire. Blood that is refined from God. He wants us to be transformed in him. To live our life, to become as the bride of Christ, to put on the heavenly garment, and we put on the heavenly garment to things like prayer, fasting, spending time with God, searching ourselves, these kind of things, so that the shame, the sin that brings shame to us will be removed. And when our eyes are anointed with eyesight, we will be able to discern the things that are of God and the things that are not of God. Verse 19 says, as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten, be zealous therefore repent. Before I speak about that, I have heard a lot of believers saying this thing. And I realize believers who say this thing that the ones who actually love to live in sin. Anytime there be a correct in there, it might be generally, most of the time, they will just say, you're judging. But they say that they don't read their Bible properly. There's a scripture that says, do not judge by appearance. Just cannot judge, let's say, by appearance, because I see him looking a kind of way, moving a kind of way. That's not the right way to judge. But we should judge righteously based on the word of God. But they just don't want nobody to correct them because they want to learn this thing, so they start to accuse us of judging them. But the reason why we ought to correct, not just I correct you all, I don't look correct myself and people are supposed to correct me as well if they see me doing wrong. Right? And God, let's correct us because he loves us. Remember, God does not want us to perish. That's the reason why he came to die for us. And he wants us to get right. And when he corrects us, because he disapproves these things that are not of God. He, remember, God and Satan are opposites. Eh? The thing that God is for, the devil is not for. The thing that the devil is for, God is not for. Right? And he will discipline us and desire that we will have a zeal, a great compassion, and to really run after God, right? And to repent, to turn from those evil and sinful ways, right? God will correct us because he hates us. People don't think when you're not agreeing with their ways, that they hate them. But they don't understand. They believe that because they're blind and they don't understand God. You know, but if we really and truly, if we are, any one of us here, or anybody who may listen to my video, if we really want to serve God, we will do like David, and say, Psalm 51:10 says, create in me a clean heart and renew our spirit. We have to come, if we really want God and want to come out from that state of lukewarmness, we have to humble ourselves. Verse 20 says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me. What door is he speaking a true bottle just burst open your house like if it's a thief. God is not a thief. The devil is a thief. God is not. How does he knock? Through his word. When we hear his word. Anytime we hear anything about God, that God knocks him. Give us the opportunity to open the door for our hearts to him. I want you to open the door for our hearts to him. God will come into our lives. And he will have a communication, a commune with us. Right? And verse 21 says, to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and sat and sat down with my Father in his throne. So what is he talking about overcome? We will speak about lukewarm Christians. First of all, we are going to overcome that sin that has us in lukewarmness. And as we know, as a believer in Christ, we are going to experience trials, temptations, persecution. We are going to overcome all these things to be able to get the God to have a place for us prepared in heaven. As the Bible says, he that endure to the end shall be saved. Not what people say, one saved, forever saved. That's laziness, because the lazy that one is sinner. They have to endure to the end, and you will be saved. A race, yes, and it is a marathon. You can't stop until God says, this is the end, and you're if I want to die and you go on. You have to continue until then, until the end of your life. Verse 22 says, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the churches. And yes, a lot of us hearing right now, but you know, sometimes we will be hearing and not listening. Right? You can hear me and not listen to one thing I say. Right? But I hope that we not just hear this word, but consider this word. Probably read the word again, sometimes read the word. The week. Meditate on the word and see if you are in this place of lukewarmness. Because I'm telling you, do not be deceived and think that being lukewarm, regardless of what type of lukewarm it is, that you're going to have, and you are deceiving yourself also. You have to live for God and God alone and put away the things that are not of God and get yourself right with God. So I would like to end by saying that God wants to bless us. But we can only receive the blessing or what God has for us as long as we obey to the word, obey the words of God. So I hope that this word blessed someone's heart. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.